Good morning from Moab. We are getting ready to head out over to the EJS vendor show, and I've been looking forward to that. We haven't been to that one in several years, so I'm gonna go ahead and try to get that going here. I'm pretty excited. We got some money, got my friends. Let's go check it out. All right, we have made it to the EJS Expo. We're gonna go and check it around, check out some cool vendors, see what's showing, and see if there's any new cool stuff here today. Cook Brown here. I got Greg here with the Power Welding here, Premier Power Welding. And kind of wanted to show off this product. It looked pretty cool. Wanted to show it off, be able to weld and make some repairs out on the trails here that I thought was pretty cool.
Yeah. Of course, man. So what we have is, the reason there's so many alternators is there's a ton of different vehicles that take all kinds of different alternators. So what we do is we provide an alternator so you can remove your factory alternator, put one of our alternators in place of it, and then you have to put our welding control system in, and you can weld up to 1-inch steel with this, and you can do a permanent repair. You can weld fences, gates, structural steel, pretty well anything that's steel. You can weld stick weld aluminum, but our system is designed to be take the place of your factory charging system, and when the system is off, it's your charging system. When you turn it on, you can do welding. You can run like a Makita grinder, chop saw, anything DC with our, it's about 2,000 watts that are produced by that.
And this is only for stick welding, correct?
Stick welding, we have a wire feed, flux core wire feed system, okay, too, that plugs into our system.
And what's the average cost of your system?
Average cost is around $1,700.
About $1,700, and that's like everything that's with the alternator?
That's the alternator, the control box, and the welding leads.
Okay.
The 200 amp systems. Goes clear on up to $2,300, depending on some of our larger alternators and the more expensive
stuff. Awesome. So. Cool. I think that's a really cool idea. I love the idea. Where can we get more information on you? Do you have like a...
We're at premierpowerwelder.com.
All right. So check them out. See what you guys think. Go from there, man. I'm here with Steve with Off-Road Only, and they've got an interesting sway bar that I personally have on my Jeep that I wanted to show off because I really actually like it. You guys need to check them out here.
Well, our sway lock, which we've been building for nearly 20 years now, is a true dual rate torsion bar sway bar. So there's an inner bar for flexibility, an outer bar for rigidity. By doing this setup, one side is held rigidly to the axle for rotation. The other side, we have this mechanical latch that when it's disconnected, changes from the firm on-road rate to the flexible off-road rate. The unique part of it is you don't have to be perfectly lined up like you do with sway bar disconnects to put it back together. You flip the lever, the latch pressurizes, keys back in automatically. Easy, simple way to go. We've got them for TJ, JK, JL, JT applications, front as well as rear. We have JL, JT's testing out here in Moab. We should have them available later this summer.
And that's the cool thing that I'm excited about. You say that you're going to have the rear sway bar because I think that would be the perfect complement on my Jeep JL that I have.
Put a rooftop tent on it, load it back up with camping gear to go camping. The JT crowd looking for something to get rid of the links that hang down below the frame,
yep,
as well as getting the extra capacity for the changing load conditions. The JT crowd is going to love this product.
Okay, I'm excited about that. Where can they get more information about you guys?
Offroadonly.com.
There you guys. Go check them out. I personally have their front one. I'm looking forward to the rear one. I love it, you guys. Thanks.
Thank you.
Mock built. They have an interesting product here with their tail lights because I know a lot of people are always braking there, so they've got a pretty cool solution for that, you guys.
Yes, I'm Chelsea. I'm here with Mock Belt. So we were tired of smashing tail lights. We were tired of having these really big, ugly cages around everything that still made it even bigger than what the tail light already was. So we went ahead and created these amazing tail lights that are made out of billet aluminum. They are 6160 aluminum. All modular mounting, whether it be on the top, sides, bottoms, it does not matter. Now you have places to mount anything you want. You don't have to worry about damaging your taillights. we use a backer plate that actually sandwiches your Jeep together, so now you can have 2,500 pounds static weight on your taillight. We came out with a Yeti cup holder that doubles up as a step. So if you need to get anything up on the roof, if you're short like me, it definitely comes in handy. We have your single threaded light mounts. These single threaded light mounts actually work for anything at all that has a single thread. You do not have to just use a light. We're big fabricators and engineers, so we want to make sure that everybody can do anything, and every single thing is universal that we have. So these here, not only can you use them as a grip mount for your shovel or your axe, these are great for UTVs, for holding your belts or any of your spare parts. I break belts like crazy. Now I don't have to worry about my zip ties falling off halfway down the trail and now I gotta go find my belt. And you can even do your accessory lights. So when you're doing your night crawling or night trails, you always have lights to where you can be seen and you can see your trails themselves.
That's cool. Oh, I like that. And you guys are all made here in the U.S., right?
Yes, we're actually sourced and manufactured in the U.S.
Okay, that's awesome. I always love supporting you. Can we get more information about you guys?
If you want to get more information, you can follow us on our social medias, or if you would like, mockbuilt.com. You can follow us and find out all of our new products and get any information there. If you wanted to contact me, please email me ckasel@mockbuilt.com.
Cool. All right, well, hey, I appreciate your time. Thank you very much. I love the product, love the new ideas. Cool, thank you.
Awesome, absolutely. Thank you guys so much. Take care.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure. So this is the world's most efficient camp shower. We're kind of running low on water in here, but I'll turn it on for what's left and you can feel it. I'll turn the pump on. Anyways. Yeah, get squeezed in that. Nice hot water.
Nice.
Yeah. So you can take a 10 to 15 minute hot shower with less than a gallon of water. And the way we do that is just through that sponge, because instead of spraying water at you, you're just putting it where you need it.
Nice.
Yeah.
I like that. And this is, you said this is heated, right?
Okay. Yes, so it has an electric heater that runs off either your car's cigarette lighter or like a battery like this.
Okay.
And it heats it up itself, and then you take your shower. There is another option though, if you don't want to run a heater.
Mm-hmm.
You can just use whatever camp stove you like. So this is Jet Boil, and the ratio, this is perfectly built for 3 liters. So we put 2 liters of cold water in, and then we boil 1 liter in this, which takes about 100 seconds, so it's really quick. Pour that in, and it's perfect shower temperature. So you're ready to take a hot shower in like 2 or 3 minutes.
That's cool.
Yeah, it's really sweet.
I've seen a lot of stuff about this. Well, I'm here with American Adventure Labs again, one of my favorite companies. You guys know me. If you guys have seen the back of my rig, you know how much I love their guys' stuff. And kind of wanted to show off some of their new trailers here with some of the new drawers that they have, man.
Yeah, so
they're full length too.
They're close. We left some room in the back so that people could do batteries and accessories like shovels and things like that. So, but we do have the full length version coming.
Okay. Nice. So these are kind of built to the same standards, which is just longer for the
They're
bed
longer,
here.
And the drawers are built to be outside. So
okay.
If you notice up here, there's a rubber seal
that
runs on the inside. This we call a drip rail. It's angled down so the water doesn't run back uphill.
I got you.
And fall into the drawers. And if you notice, the drawer face, like, sinks into the shell.
Oh, okay.
So this is specifically made to be an outdoor drawer.
Okay, that's cool. Love the racks here and stuff like that.
Yep. So this is our 6-inch version, and that's the 12-inch.
Okay.
If you notice, they use the same spreaders, and then we do a filler plate in the middle. So that way, if you bought 6-inch and wanted to go to 12, you would just have to buy the risers on the sides.
Okay. What's the static load on these things?
I'm not sure yet. You're looking at the sort of pre-production version.
Oh, okay. Is it going to be designed for like roof tents and stuff like that to be able to handle that?
And the cool thing about it with our bed rail system, you can add as many loads as you want.
Gotcha.
So this rack here, this piece weighs 70 pounds, which is super light. License title.
Guys are always coming up with like cool designs.
They need to check this out.
Yeah, guys, American Adventure Lab, you have to check them out. I have more of their products than I know how to count. So
collect the whole set.
Dude, I really am, man. The flip and slide, I love that thing. I use that all the time. We use that on the last couple trips that we've gone on and everything. Oh, that's cool, dude. Oh, man. All right. Cool, man. I love meeting up with you and seeing the new products,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah, we like watching the channel grow and everything. It's pretty cool.
It's getting there, dude. I appreciate it. Thank you. American Adventure Labs, guys. Check them out. They're awesome.